for this project, stop motion feels like it's the best form of animation to follow. Because I feel, personally, I feel that stop motion works well for Christmas because you do have a little bit of a nostalgia going for the previous specials that have been done in the past, but also there's something about the puppets that you animate that make them kind of feel like toys. So there's a very toy-like feel about stop motion animation that you feel like you can go in there into the screen and just reach and grab that really cool looking puppet. I think that's what, in my personal opinion, that's what creates the charisma of those of doing it in stop motion. Stop motion animation is a form of animation that you build a puppet, and inside that puppet is a metal skeleton. It's called an armature, and it's tensioned in a way that you can move a limb or a head or the whole body, and you make that pose and you take a photo, and then you move on to the next pose and you take a photo and so on. And once you start playing all that together, then you start seeing the character come to life. As we jumped into production for this, we automatically started thinking about what kind of music we use for the project, because the music is its own personality that has to be an integral part of the special right away. And luckily, the music already came with the project, and we were able to contact the composers and start collaborating with them on how we wanted to handle the music, because we really wanted it to be its own personality apart from either project. And so Seamus and I went ahead and we spent days just locked up in a room playing all sorts of kinds of music and stuff, and we wrote this huge treatment about how we wanted to treat the music and how it directly affects the characters and making it organic to the story. And so we wanted to sort of give certain themes to each song to sort of help emphasize some of the scenes where Buddy's traveling along the ocean into exotic lands to find his father. He's sort of singing to himself. And so we wanted to come up with an idea of what kind of theme can we do with that travel. Can it be nautical? Can it be whatever, you know? And so we're constantly thinking about music and musicality in the animation as well. We normally would have on a project like this about a year and a half to tackle, but this time around we had about 8 months. And we accepted the challenge because there's something liberating about not having to have to overwork a project so much and thinking too much and like trying all these different things out. Sometimes it's really cool when you're just sort of going instinctual with your decisions on how to build a puppet, on how to design it, and how to move it. And so we didn't have a lot of time, but we kind of saw it as a half full kind of approach to it.